back. Homemade eggnog is a tradition for a lot of families over the holidays, but this delicious and creamy drink can actually make you sick. Nutrition professor Susan Mills Gray actually joins us now in the Price Chopper kitchen.
Good morning.
Yes, good morning and happy holidays. Thanks. You brought this festive drink here.
I love eggnog. I grew up eating or drinking eggnog, but there was an adult version and a children's version.
Okay.
And some had nog and some didn't have nog. So
okay.
One of the things that we want to share today is that homemade eggnog is perfectly fine if you follow a particular recipe. Okay. And I provided that for the studio to show and to share with our consumers that might be out there.
Oh, so important there. And you're talking about starting with a cooked egg or maybe a substitute.
Right.
So how do we do that?
So most homemade eggnog recipes start with raw eggs.
Mm-hmm.
And so our suggestion is, and this is also coming from FDA.
Yeah, important.
And that is to start with a cooked eggnog base. So you're going to take the eggs that are called for in your recipe, mm-hmm. crack them and stir them well. Add half of the milk that's called for in your recipe, put that on a saucepan, low heat, stirring constantly, and using a candy thermometer to cook that until 160 degrees. Chill it, and then after it's cold, add all the rest of the ingredients and serve it. You really can't tell that big of difference.
And it'll be so delicious.
And it will.
It just says like Christmas time, holidays to a lot of people. One thing though, why it's so important that we use that cooked egg or maybe even an egg substitute.
Right.
There, we could run into salmonella.
Eggs can, on the surface of the shell contain many times salmonella, and that is the most prevalent and the most common form of foodborne bacteria. And we don't want to upset the holidays by making ourselves sick, our family sick. So you do have a couple of options. You can use the cooked egg base recipe that we've shared. You could also use what we call an egg substitute because this is pasteurized.
Okay.
Another option is that you can actually find in the grocery store cartons of pasteurized eggs.
Wow.
So they've been treated. The egg is still raw, but the surface has been treated to reduce that chance of salmonella. So you do have those options.
Okay, well that's gonna cut down on a lot of
things
that people could be worried about, so you can still enjoy the eggnog. One thing, some people maybe have this misconception, if it's got that nog in it, if it's got that little extra alcohol in it, that's
so you can
really not gonna make us safer.
You and I were talking before we went on, you can add as much whiskey, you can add as much rum as you want, but you're not gonna kill salmonella bacteria.
Mm-hmm.
And so a lot of people think that's why if you add enough alcohol, then you're going to destroy whatever bacteria is in that, and that's just not true. So adding extra nog to your eggnog is not going to make that any safer. And so, you know, the groups that are the most vulnerable for this are the older, our older population and the very young. And of course, we wouldn't serve young children anything that had alcohol in it, but a lot of older adults may enjoy that. So that's why, you know, using the egg substitutes or pasteurized egg or using the cooked egg base for your eggnog makes this an extremely healthy way to celebrate the holidays.
Okay, Susan, that was an amazing tip for us. Before we go, I do want to know, do you have a great eggnog story from maybe your childhood? You were saying,
I'm
drinking this with the
family. My grandma Madeline was the eggnog maker for our family.
Okay.
And there was always this huge punch bowl full of eggnog. And it was always, I said, now remember, this one is for the adults, and then this little bowl over here is for the kids.
Uh-huh.
And when you're young, I knew the adult one had a cinnamon on the top, and ours did not, so I thought that was the difference.
Uh-huh.
I was a teenager before I figured out what the difference was.
Okay, well, that's funny, and props to Grandma Madeline for keeping everybody safe. Oh, thank you so much, Susan.
Okay.
We appreciate it.